So to show your controller on stream using OBS, the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to grab your controller, and you're going to want to go ahead and use the charging cable, plug it into the remote, and then plug the other end instead inside of your console. You want to plug it in directly to your computer. Once you have that plugged in, you're going to want to visit a website called gamepadviewer.com, and I'll put a link in the description of this video. Once you're here, you're going to see there are currently no gamepads connected. Press any button to enable. This is why you want to have your controller connected to your computer. So I'm going to push a button. You're going to see here that that message is going to disappear. And then at the top here, you're going to want to select Xbox, and then you can select Xbox White. And then here where it says currently viewing, you're going to want to select player one. You're going to see here that the controller has now appeared. And when I'm touching buttons, you'll see that that's happening directly on the screen. So once you have that there, what you're going to want to do on the left hand side, you're going to select this little three little lines here. You're going to come where it says generate URL. And what you want to do here is under skin, if you want a black Xbox controller, leave it as default. If you want a white one, then you want to make sure you select white. Then what you want to do is you want to go ahead and copy this link here. And now what we want to do is we want to come back into OBS, and you're going to want to find the scene that you're going to want to add the controller to. And then under sources, you're going to press the plus button. You're going to come to where it says browser. You're going to name this controller, and then you're going to select OK. And what you're going to do here under URL is that you're going to go ahead and paste that link. And then for the width, you're going to make sure you put 900 by 700. And then you simply select OK. It's going to go ahead and pop up there. You're going to see it's going to say disconnected. So what you want to do is you're going to want to go ahead and push a button on your controller, and you're going to see that the controller is now visible. So what you simply can do, you can go ahead and resize it, place it anywhere that you like. And now when I'm pushing buttons on the controller, you can see here that it's all moving and it's all functional, and you're ready to go ahead and go live. Now, if you want to be able to learn how to be able to grow your stream, I've created the Ultimate Streamer Checklist, which is the ultimate guide to tell you what to do before you go live, what to do during your stream to be able to get views and followers and subscriptions, and what to do after your live stream to be able to get more people to find you so you can actually grow. So go to the description of this video to download that free guide. You can be able to know exactly what it is you need to do. And then if you want to learn how to add overlays inside of your OBS studio, go ahead and watch this video right here where I give you free overlays that you can utilize, and I even show you how to set them all up. I'll see you guys in the next video.